Hi, folks. Artist Mac here. And if you are not familiar with these two parts, it means you have an automatic Fiero or you've never owned a Fiero. But eventually, if you have a manual Fiero, you will have to replace one or both of these parts. This was a huge box compared to the size of the parts that it held. And imagine me carrying this home under my arm on a bicycle, looking like the UPS thief. Oh well, you do what you gotta do. The one on the left is a clutch master cylinder. That's the part that goes under what would be the hood on the Fiero. It's the trunk, and that's what you fill with clutch fluid every once in a while if it starts getting low. This is a steel clutch pedal, as opposed to the aluminum clutch pedal that originally came on Fieros back in '84. And I'll give you a perfect example. Now, if you've just bought a Fiero and you want to check whether your clutch pedal assembly is steel or aluminum, just put a magnet up to it. In my case, I'm using a refrigerator magnet. It works exactly the same way. Okay, you put the magnet on there. If it's steel, it sticks. If it's aluminum, it doesn't. And since this is the original clutch pedal from 34 years ago, it's definitely the aluminum. In all fairness, they did use aluminum on the brake pedal, but the brake pedal doesn't get nearly as much use in a manual Fiero or a manual any other car as the clutch pedal does. You have to press it down every time you change gears. You have to press it down every time you come to a stop, and you do a lot of stopping in big city traffic. And because of the people who are concerned for our safety, in contrast to the 74 TR6 I used to have, in the Fiero, you have to press the clutch down every time you start the car. Now, this is supposed to keep you from accidentally starting the car in gear and, you know, the car lurches forward. Well, I mean, it happened a couple of times to me in the TR6, and what did I learn? Yeah. So with a Fiero or any other manual car in city traffic, the clutch pedal gets much more use than the brake pedal. And a viewer had told me to try bending the aluminum clutch pedal back, and I did with just my hand. I mean, it came up at least an inch, and I didn't realize that the clutch pedal was so much farther forward than the brake pedal, since I was always seeing it from the driver's seat, and they looked like they're the same distance. All right, this is the page out of the service manual that shows the master cylinder and clutch pedal assembly. And you can see the bolt with the nut that you have to get out and slide it over to get the clutch pedal out. It also shows you the arrangement of how the banjo fits on to this pin on the pedal assembly. What it does not show you is this. That does not appear in any service manual drawing I've ever seen. And obviously I'm gonna have to get that out. Thank you, phone. Yeah, obviously I'm gonna have to get that out. Or maybe
It's hard to say. Ugh. Maybe I can do this without getting it out. Oh, there it is. Yeah, this is the attachment of the banjo to the pedal assembly. Right there in the middle, as if I put my finger up in there, you won't be able to see it. And I can't show it to you because it's so far up in there. But the nut that I'm gonna need to take off to get the pedal assembly out, and where is it? Yeah, there it is. Right in the middle there, you can see the shaft that both the brake pedal and the clutch pedal assembly are on. Boy, it is tight up in there. But anyway, I'll get it out. And I don't know what this thing is. Let's see, I'm pressing the clutch pedal. And whatever it is, it's the clutch pedal's pulling it right along with it. Oh boy. It's never a dull moment. And I can't even see how that fits on there. We'll get it figured out.
And all of this agony for me and other manual Fiero owners could have been prevented in the first place if Pontiac had just used a steel clutch pedal assembly. I mean, how much weight were they saving with aluminum? The steel one is only 2 pounds. On a 2,500-pound car, that's nothing. You know, I wondered how I was going to get this banjo, that's what they call the end of the rod of the master cylinder, off of the clutch pedal assembly. As it turns out, it moves, it swivels, so that should make the job a little bit easier. One thing that I've already noticed is this does not go on here easily. I'm going to try some Vaseline and some WD-40, but it's not going on there just as I was expecting. So that may be an issue. But I don't know if you can see it here, but here's the hole where the cotter pin goes in, or the clip, or whatever they're calling it. So anyway, we will be installing these in the next exciting episode of What the Clutch? This is Artist Mac, signing off.